Hello everybody, this is Kapaloo and I am back with a question for you. I have a series of questions that I have specifically geared to those of you women who are involved in ministry. Maybe you serve alongside your husband, perhaps your first lady or minister's wife. I am a minister's wife, so I think that you and I might have some things in common and we might have some things to dialogue about on this video. I have a few questions concerning the wearing of hats and proper coverings within the church. Being a pastor's wife or a first lady or a leader in the church who serves beside her husband, there are certain expectations within the church that have always been, through the years, traditionally have come to be indoctrinated within the church. And sometimes these ideas and traditions are accepted as the rule or as the law. And sometimes they're just not. I'm not suggesting that wearing head coverings and hats are not scriptural, because I believe that there are some principles within the books, especially the book of Corinthians, that specifically speaks to women wearing a covering on their head. So I believe that there is some scriptural reference to support women covering their hair. But do you think, as a woman in ministry with your husband, do you believe that you are not wearing a hat if you don't wear one? And in my case, I don't wear one every Sunday. I wear them every now and then. Do you believe that not wearing a hat makes you any less involved in a personal relationship with Christ? Do you believe that you're not choosing to wear a hat makes you not a good Christian or a good minister's wife or pastor's wife? And I just really want to hear your opinions on these, because I have been admonished on more than one occasion, and I believe it has been done in love, but on more than one occasion, some of the mothers or elders in the church have spoken to me and said that you would look so much nicer if you would wear a hat, or that suit would really be set off with the right kind of hat. And those innuendos have troubled me at times, because I believe that God does not look at the outer man. It's not the garment. It's not the clothes that he's looking at. He is concerned about the hearts. And I know what chapter 11 of Corinthians says. It does say some things about women covering their head, and that it's a symbol of authority on our head. There are a lot of good points that are brought out in this chapter that bear reference to a validity of wearing a head covering. It says something here in verse 6 about, for if a woman is not covered, let her also be shorn or shaved. But if it is shameful for a woman to be shaved, let her be covered. So in other words, if you feel comfortable, you're not wearing a covering, or I'm not wearing a covering over my head, is the same as going bald or not being shaved, not having any hair at all. The entire chapter of 11 gives great reference and gives great supporting information as to why it is important to wear a head covering. They say that Paul said that it was a dishonor, and because the man is the head of woman as Christ is the head of man, then it is a symbolic reference to our adhering to our husbands by covering our head. And I do teach in the church. I do speak when I'm asked. And I serve in the church and ministry over certain ministries. And I have noticed that many of those times I don't wear my hair covered. And I don't know if that makes me a bad Christian, or if it makes me not be one that is in a submission to God's word in this aspect. But I have not gotten this in my spirit yet. This has not gotten into my spirit yet. If it is that I'm not following the word according to the scripture. It has not gotten into my spirit yet, because in the same chapter around verse 15, it says this, but if a woman has long hair, it is a glory to her, for her hair is given to her as a covering. And for many years, I have adopted that and let that be my covering. I've worn my hair long for years, and I've always been comfortable with not wearing a hat on my head. And I never felt any less of a woman. I never felt like I was lessening my husband's authority over me or his government, his governing. I never felt like I was doing any of that by not wearing a hat. And I believe that some feel that that is the case. And I really would like to hear what you all's thoughts are on that, for clarity. Not so much to change my mind, but that I might be able to, I can call him back. Not that this was going to be a dishonor to God. I believe and without a doubt know that I have a personal relationship with my Heavenly Father. And I do not believe that when I go before Him in prayer or in meditation that He's unpleased with me because I'm not covering my hair. I know that there are some very old ideas and very old dogma within the church that have been passed down through the years that have pushed that on to us and almost make it seem like if you're not in that, if you're not adopting that principle, that you're not walking in the Lord right, that there's something short in your walk. And I have not received that into my spirit. I have been studying a little bit more, and I do believe that it is beautiful for women to wrap their hair. I have mine wrapped today, and I have been doing it more frequently. On those days that I don't particularly wear hats to church, I will wrap my hair. And ever since I've had my locks, I've done that. I've done it not as often as I probably should, but I have wrapped my hair up. I use fabric somewhat like this, so I'll use some kente cloth or something, and I'll wrap my hair up with all sorts of beautiful scarves. And I do it because it keeps my locks healthy, and I think it's beautiful. I think it's regal. I think it's royal, and I have done it for those reasons, but I've not ever done it for the reason that Paul outlined in the scripture with concern of that, and I don't know if that is a bad thing. I just have not received that in my spirit yet. I am asking you to share your thoughts, what your opinion, biblical views are concerning that, because I don't believe that we are any less Christian or any less of a woman of God if we don't do that. But the Lord is speaking to me in this aspect, and I got to be honest. I asked one of my friends here on YouTube, Lifey09, and if you have not been to her channel, go to her channel. She has a beautiful spirit, and very knowledgeable, and I love to listen to her minister. But I've never seen her minister without her head covered. Every time she is on ministering or sharing the word, she is in her garment with her head wrapped. And when I asked her why she did that, she responded back with the answer that I thought she would. And it's all good. I respect the reasons for why people do what they do. I embrace the freedom and the liberty that we have in Christ. I don't believe we all have to do the same things and walk the same way. So long as we receive Jesus as our Lord and Savior, I believe we are one in Him, and He recognizes us that way. I believe that we should practice righteousness and godliness, but that our acts and our deeds should not be simply done as a form of godliness, because we can deny the power of God simply by doing things and not having any spiritual basis for why we do what we do. I wrap my hair because I like the way it looks. And lately, God has been speaking to me about wrapping my hair up in church while I'm teaching and while I'm speaking over the ministry. And I'm praying for more insight on that, because I believe that the Lord is leading me to do that. He has not spoken to me about hats, but I like wrapping my hair up in the garments, and I feel the Lord speaking to me about that in terms of when I stand up before the assembly to confess or profess God's word, that I might cover my head. So I really want to hear what you ladies have to say. First ladies, pastors, wives, ministers, wives, let's hear from you today. And any of you who want to chime in, let's hear from you.